Hello everyone and welcome. Hope you're doing great. In my last tutorial, I've shown you guys how to connect to a database from your Spring Boot application. I have shown the example using MySQL. I have created a sample database named music_history and connected to that database. Now we'll be creating a new database tables in the database, and then we'll be working with that database from our Java application. So before moving to the next step, like creating an entity or model class, I'd like to dive deeper so that we can understand some core concept in Java web development. In relational database, what are the main component? We have database tables. In database table, we have row, column, and in object-oriented programming, everything we do is an object. We write a class and then make object of that class. So there are two different things here. One is relational database and other one is object-oriented programming or Java. Since we'll be doing operation with database, if we somehow convert the database table into a class, that will be very convenient for our typical work, because in object-oriented programming, this is what we want to do. We want to represent that as a class and then make an object. So in my case, let's say we have a table named artist, and in that table we have some column with some common property of an artist, like a name, genre, first album and others. And when we want to do our programming in Java, we will be doing that with a class as an object. So this is where ORM comes in. ORM means object-relational mapping. The main concern, the main bridge I'm talking about between the relational database and the object-oriented programming is given by the object-relational mapping, or ORM. I think you got the basic idea about ORM. Now what is JPA? JPA stands for Java Persistence API. So JPA is some specification. JPA actually provides some standardized way to perform ORM in a Java application. Since we need ORM, we need some standardized specification so that we can work in a convenient way. It is like a protocol. We have some common guideline everywhere, and that is very development friendly. So what JPA does is JPA work as an interface which provides some abstract guideline how to do what in terms of database operation, and an ORM like Hibernate or MyVTs implements the JPA. Okay, so JPA is an interface or a standardized way to perform ORM operation in Java, and Hibernate is one of the most popular and feature-rich implementation of JPA specification. Okay, so if JPA is an interface, Hibernate is its implementation. But in object-oriented design, if you have the idea of polymorphism, we want to declare a variable as an abstract class or interface, like list l equal to new air list, so that we can work in a flexible way. Here is the similar idea. If we use JPA, we can use Hibernate or MyVTs, whatever we want. But the common pattern, like find all, save and find by ID, all the methods are gonna be same even if we change the ORM. Let's talk about Hibernate now. Hibernate is the most popular and feature-rich implementation of JPA, and it is the default implementation in a Spring Boot application. So when you add Spring Data JPA in your application, Hibernate will be automatically configured behind the scene. But if you want to use JPA as a specification, but you want to use something else as an ORM implementation, then you have to manually configure that. You can do that. So I hope you got the idea why we need ORM, what is JPA and what is Hibernate. All those things came up because relational database is one thing, object-oriented programming is one thing, and we need to solve a problem with our application combining both. And that's why this is very important to a Java developer to know about ORM, knowing about Hibernate and other stuff. So I hope you got the idea. In my next tutorial, I'll be showing you how to convert a database table to a class which you'll be calling an entity. One thing I want to mention here is, if you have learned something out of this tutorial and want me to make more similar helpful content, then please consider subscribing to my channel and hit the like button, because that will actually motivate me to make similar content and continue this series. Thank you so much for watching.